Janet.
That's my girl.
You are embarking on a new project. You have a new album, a new record label. Tell us about the album and how the project evolved.
During Rhythm Nation, it was an idea that I had to go a little further, do something that I hadn't done before, basically trying to do that with each project. And it's about love, the highs and the lows of love. That's what this album is about.
Is this a new Janet we're hearing?
I guess you could say it's a new Janet for the public, but not for myself, just something that the public hasn't heard before, but yet still a part of me.
Come with me, don't you worry. I'm gonna make it crazy. I'll give you the time of your life. I'm gonna take you places you've never been before, and you'll be so happy that you came.
I hope this puts to rest. I hope this finally put to rest another rumor that has been in the press for too many years. Me and Janet really are two different people.
For his sister Janet, it means a lot. She's finally on the way out of her brother's shadow.
You're famous, very talented, and yet have you ever sat down to an interview and not been asked about your brother Michael?
Yes, I think probably twice, maybe in my life. It doesn't happen very often, though.
One of the finest sisters in the music industry, Miss Janet
dreams. There's nothing more depressing than having everything and still feeling sad.
To the outside world, Janet Jackson seems to have everything.
It's not about having everything, and that's what people have to understand. They think, oh, you can pay all your bills. What are you complaining about? It's not about that. I'm human just like the next person, and I have pain just like the next person.
How did you, or when did you, start defining who you were to yourself?
I realized that some of the things that I do, I mean, I knew I was doing it, but I would ignore it, like suppressing certain feelings and things like that, and certain things I was taught to do and thought, okay, this is the way life is supposed to be, and realizing, no, if I don't like it, then I can change it. This is my life. I don't want it to be this way, and I don't want to feel this way, so I'm in control of that, and I've got to do something about it.
And that something was learning to be comfortable in her own skin.
And getting to that point was a very difficult space for myself. Being comfortable with who you are and liking yourself for you and not what society says you're supposed to look like, how you're supposed to be, but being happy with yourself and what's inside.
The pain Janet felt would eventually lead to battling and overcoming depression.
If you had to say it in one affirmation, the affirmation that for you helped you climb out of that dark place, what was it? What was it that got you out of there?
It was that little tiny light of of hope, really, is what it was. And sometimes I could barely see it. I could barely see it. And sometimes I felt like the walls were just closing in on me.
You just felt like it would never get better?
Yes, there were times when I thought this was it. This was it. And I thought I'd never get out of this. And I mean, it's just like this dark tunnel. And it was getting brighter and brighter, and eventually I got through it. But there were times when it would, you know, it would get very small again.
Welcome the recipient of the 1997 Soul Train Lady of Soul Awards, the Lena Horne Award for Outstanding Career Achievement, Miss Janet Jackson.
Life can sometimes take turns that even the most skilled navigators cannot anticipate. Thankfully, many of us have the support and love of others to help us stay on our path and to help us meet our goals and dreams. Receiving this award is a great honor, and I am very grateful to all of you for this recognition. But I couldn't be here tonight with you without the many persons, like my mother, Dr. Angelo, and Miss Lena Horne. And who continue to touch my life in ways that allow me to be who I am. Recently, I wrote a song entitled Can't Be Stopped. The message that I wanted to communicate is this: you can go anywhere you want to, as long as you don't forget where you come from.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay, here we go.
She's taught many people to accept themselves for who they are, and no matter what, they're beautiful people.
About what she feels. So you always have kind of a sense of what's going on in her life at that particular moment.
I just write what I'm feeling in my heart, what goes on in my life. You know, as a kid, I could never keep a journal, I could never keep a diary, and I tried. And I saw other kids do it, and I thought I was just weird or different in that way. And then I came to realize as I got older that my albums are my journals. There are definitely songs that just feel right, that feel good. That you could see the top down, you're in the car, you're cruising, it's summertime,
and you say, yeah, I could hear this on the radio. And I hope people like it the way I'm feeling it. I really enjoy listening to Would You Mind? You know, it's so funny. The band was playing that song, and it's really weird because everyone's interacting and talking, and when that song comes on, everyone gets really weird. I think everyone's a little bit embarrassed, except for me. I'm the one that's still carrying on, but that's one that I enjoy listening to.
Catastrophe.